guys, welcome to Tarzara's Kitchen. I am Mansi. I'm going to show you a very famous and interesting recipe that is Lajjadar Handi Biryani, which you can enjoy with your choice of raita. So first step for making the Handi Biryani, we're going to cook the rice. We'll heat some oil first. I've taken a deep nonstick pan here. Now we'll add the spices, some green cardamom, one black cardamom, two cloves, one cinnamon, and bay leaf. We'll just saute this for a few seconds so that the spices release their flavor. Yes, the spices have started releasing their aroma, and now we'll add the rice. I've taken basmati rice over here and I've soaked this for about 10 minutes in water and then I've drained it. Now we'll add the milk. Lower the flame. Some salt. We'll just give it a mix. Now this is mixed well. And now we'll cover it and cook it for about 8 to 10 minutes. We'll check once in between. We'll give it a stir. Now remember to cook it on a slow flame, because if you're cooking it on a high flame and covering it with a lid, it's going to come out. Now till this is being cooked, we'll prepare the dahi mixture. I've taken curd over here. I'll add some garam masala in this, some cardamom powder and some salt. And just give it a mix. This I'm going to put it in the biryani when we're going to layer the rice and the chana masala. So we'll keep this aside. Till then, we'll again check the rice. Yes, you can see the milk has almost evaporated and the rice also seems cooked. It's looking so creamy, that means it's done. We'll switch out the flame and now we'll start making the chana masala. First, we'll heat some ghee. I've taken a kadhai over here. Now, as this is a Mughlai recipe, it's going to take a lot of ghee and that is what the flavor is going to come. And now the ginger garlic paste. We just saute this for about 30 seconds till all the garlic and ginger flavor have released. Now we'll add the tomatoes and cook this on a medium flame for about 1 minute. Now for the spice, we'll add some finely chopped green chilies, some chili powder, and some turmeric powder. Just give it a mix. Cook it for about 30 seconds. You can see what a nice color has come. Now we'll add some parboiled potato cubes. I've boiled, peeled, and cubed these potatoes, soaked and boiled kala chana. Some whisked curds. This is one of the main ingredients. And finally, some salt. And mix all this very well. We'll lower the flame because as we've added curd, it will start curdling. And that's what we do not want. Mix this very well and we'll cook for about 1 to 2 minutes. Now here I haven't taken completely cooked potatoes. It's because it's going to get again cooked when we are going to layer it in the handi. This has been done. We'll switch off the flame and now we'll start layering the biryani. So now the best part, we'll start layering the handi biryani. I've taken a handi over here, but if you do not have it at home, you can use a deep pan. So first, we'll start layering the chana masala that we have prepared. And we'll just spread it out evenly at the bottom of the handi. Now we'll sprinkle some coriander over it. These greens are going to give a very nice flavor to this biryani. Next goes the mint leaves. Some ginger. Now this is optional over here because some people do not like the flavor of whole ginger. You can avoid it or you can add a little bit less. Some sliced green chilies, This is also your choice. If you like it spicy, you can add more. Now the curd mixture that we had prepared, we're going to evenly spread it around. With this, you're going to get a very nice and creamy texture of the handi biryani. And plus, it's going to give it a very rich flavor. And now the rice layer. Make sure you evenly layer it. I'm sure this is going to be a complete meal for your family. Just evenly spread it out like this. Even this out with the back of a spoon so that you get a very nice even layer. See, it's so nicely layered now. And finally, the last step, we'll pour this milk and saffron mixture. I've taken 1/4 teaspoon of saffron and soaked it in warm milk. This is going to give a very nice and rich color to this biryani, like just like the Mughals. And finally, the sprinkling of fried onions. And this is a must for most of the biryanis. It gives a very nice flavor, and especially to the handi biryani and also dum biryani. So now this is done. The next step, we'll cover it with the lid. And I've taken whole wheat dough over here. What you have to do is, you have to roll it like this and cover the edges of the handi. So this is the dough that I have rolled. Now you just have to put it on the edges and stick it. The reason why we are doing this is that no air from the handi has to come out, and that is when the biryani will cook evenly from inside. Flatten it out like this so that it gets stuck very nicely. So this is done. It has been sealed very nicely, and now we'll put this on the flame and cook it on a slow flame for 10 to 15 minutes. Make sure you're cooking it on a slow flame. Do not increase the flame, otherwise it'll get burnt at the bottom. It's been 15 minutes already now. We'll switch off the flame, and the dough has become a bit hard, and that is a sign that it has been cooked. We'll remove it from the gas and let it to cool for about 5 minutes so that it's easily removable. It has cooled down a little bit. Now we'll just remove it. You can see it's become very hard. It's coming off easily. Wow, it's looking so good and so colorful. And what you have to do is now just serve it. I'll just show you one part of it. This is how it's going to look. So just sit with your family and enjoy it on the dinner table, and let me know how you like it. Bye.
Download the Tarla Dalal app on your Apple and Android devices. Follow us on the Facebook and tarladalal.com. If you enjoy our recipes, click like. To see more of my recipes, click here. Please share your comments. I would love to hear them. I'm waiting for them.